Now, you guys, I want you to hit the like button, right? Don't take this personally, but, I think I hate you. What's up, everybody? AnimeXU, and in this video, I will be doing, yes, yet another part to What If Naruto Was in MHA. This is obviously the part 6, as the title thumbnail suggests, but the reason that I'm doing this is because you guys hit the like goal. If you guys watched previous parts of the series, you know that I make the last like goal 200. Obviously, since this video is coming out, you guys hit that like goal, so I'm gonna up the ante quite a bit to 300 likes in part 7 comes out immediately. Now, like always, I'll be recapping the last part of the series and jumping right back into the action. And so, without further ado, let's get started. Now, before I get into the recap, I just have to make two quick announcements. Both have to do with the Masked Man. One, the first one that I want to bring up is kind of more negative, but it's whatever. For all of you that sub to Masked Man and watch his videos, he didn't steal my idea about the ex Naruto character in MHA. Like, that's we talked about it, so relax. Also, shout out to him because he's the one who made my new profile picture that I'm using in my videos now. So I appreciate it. So I'll leave a link to his channel in the description below if I remember. If I don't remember, yell at me in the comments for it, because I'll switch that up, you know. I forget sometimes. Now, in the last part of What If Naruto Was in MHA, we see that Naruto, along with the rest of Class 1A, were in USJ and attacked by the villains, the League of Villains, or at least part of them. During that attack, Midoriya and Naruto went berserk, unleashed some latent power inside of him, and allowed them to go toe-to-toe with the Nomus for a bit. After that, All Might came, saved them, and we left off with Naruto and Midoriya, both attempting to learn how to harness the power they just had, and that's where we'll be starting this What If. Now, like I said earlier in the recap, Naruto and Midoriya want to learn how to harness the power that they use against a Nomu, since it far surpassed their own limitations that they have set on themselves. For Naruto, he has no idea where to start, and the same goes for Midoriya. They both know that they need to learn how to harness their newfound abilities quickly, with the UA Sports Festival coming up extremely soon. So, for a while, they are supposed to be recovering. Naruto and Midoriya sneak out in order to get some much-needed training in. Now, Naruto keeps this hypothesis to himself but Naruto has a sneaking suspicion that Midoriya unlocked a very rare ability that Naruto, as a chakra user, is now aware of, the 8 Inner Gates. Now, the reason he thinks this is because Midoriya suddenly burst through his limits with of pain and power. This leads Naruto to the conclusion that Midoriya was able to forcibly open at least one of the gates, maybe even two, with sheer power, which is an amazingly difficult feat to pull off without training and without knowledge of these gates even existing. Likewise, Midoriya has a theory on why Naruto is unable to unlock such power himself. If you guys remember from part 1, Naruto was identified to have a very large and dense amount of chakra deeply rooted somewhere within his stomach. And while in the hospital, Midoriya overheard the nurse say that the massive chakra had been somewhat depleted, leading Midoriya to think that to the conclusion that when Naruto's enraged, he can pull from this pool of chakra, although he can't 100% confirm this since he isn't aware of how chakra works completely. After they are officially released from the hospital, they go back to attending UA regularly, and they now know that they have a single week in order to prepare for the UA Sports Festival. Now, hearing that the UA Sports Festival is so close, Naruto and Midoriya are now a little bit stressed, and because they know they are both the underdogs in the eyes of literally every hero, since they are registered as basically having a quirk at the age of 15 in Midoriya's case, and being completely quirkless in Naruto's. Now, while they're on their way to lunch, Naruto and Midoriya are explaining their theories and how they unleash their power to each other. And right after Midoriya finishes his sentence about Naruto's pool of chakra, Bakugo shoves both of them and knocks them down. After this happened, Naruto gets up and his eyes completely change for a split second. Naruto isn't even furious at Bakugo, he's just slightly annoyed, but this transformation to the Four Tails loosened the seal on Kurama quite a bit, meaning Naruto has to keep his emotions under control or definite problems will occur. Especially when someone like Bakugo exists. Now, once they sit down at the table, Uraraka and Lita sits down to them next to them to talk. Midoriya, of course, gets flustered and squirms in his seat all weird-like, and then Naruto looks up for a second and realizes that everyone but Lita and Uraraka is as far away from them as possible. And everyone looks at them in fear, and in particular, they're looking at Naruto in fear. At first, Naruto wonders why this happens, but he remembers and thinks about how scary it would have been to see someone you consider a friend completely transform into a monster and lose themselves. While Naruto is kind of sad and angry because he didn't choose to do it, he can't blame them. When he transformed, he lost all control of his restraints and limits, and even he was scared of what he became. Naruto knew in his heart that he might transform again soon if he tried to rely on that monstrous power. In fact, he was aware that if Nomu went there, he would have probably killed or at least tried to kill other students or really anyone that stood in the way of him fighting someone. And with that realization, a single tear drops from Naruto's face on the table, and seeing his friend, his best friend in the whole world, being ridiculed and discriminated against makes his blood boil. In fact, this makes Naruto stand up on the table and doing something out of character, which is do something that Naruto should have done and yell out to the cafeteria that Naruto is a hero, that he saved everyone, when no one else would step up, and he decided to get up and fight the Nomu for them. Seeing this, Naruto stands up on the table and yells out something close to his signature line and says that he and Midoriya are going to become the number one heroes and to, you say it with me now, believe it. After the fiasco, the school day is over, Naruto and Midoriya head out from school, and then Naruto tells Midoriya that until the UA Sports Festival are over, they are rivals and competitors, and they both high-five each other as they both have separate ways. Now, not training as friends, but as rivals for the spot of number one. Now, after their week of training is over, everyone heads to the arena and gets ready to finally show off their abilities to the hero entities that could possibly recruit them. So, as you guys know, the first event is the obstacle course race, but right before that happens, Midoriya and Naruto find each other and wave, and then, with their sly smiles, they both look ahead into the race, knowing that whoever is going to win this thing is going to be the one that shows off their trump card last. And with that, they get the signal to start, and they do. They're off to the races. And Midoriya is dusting everyone in this race. Keep in mind that Midoriya won without using his quirk, so with full cowl, this should make it fairly easy. Except for the fact that Bakugo and Todoroki have been training to finally beat and completely snuff out Naruto and Midoriya, so Bakugo's speed with explosions has now increased dramatically, and Todoroki's ice and the entire field to begin with, meaning that the top three people are Bakugo, Midoriya, and Todoroki. Trailing behind in fourth is Naruto, who decides that he'll stay in fourth in order to get a grip on what Todoroki and Bakugo could do now, since he knows that Midoriya won't show off any new abilities until he absolutely has to. Besides, the race is rather uneventful, with Midoriya still being able to pull off an early win in the Sports Festival. This leaves Bakugo in second, Todoroki in third, and Naruto in fourth. For the sake of simplicity, we'll say that everyone else still qualifies, just because if I discount one person, then the entire structure changes of the fight. So we now move on to the Cavalry Battle. Now, due to Naruto's presence in this event, this basically means that one person will have to fight this battle alone without the help of anyone. Also, now obviously most of the teams will go very similar to how they do the original, and the only difference that Midoriya offers to team up with Naruto, but Naruto declines, saying that he's fine with being alone for this battle, and he needs to be able to take him on his own anyways. Also, Naruto is kind of hated by everyone who saw him transform, so that's fine with him anyway. And with that, Naruto makes two shadow clones, jumps on their backs, and is ready to go. And with that, Midnight Lady signal starts, and everyone is off to the races, almost everyone going for Midoriya since he has the most points. But right before anyone can close in, Midoriya's team goes airborne with Uraraka helping this. Seeing the opportunity arise, Bakugo and Naruto launch themselves at Midoriya. Bakugo gets downed and hit down by the dark shadow, and right before Naruto gets hit, he makes a shadow clone midair, throws himself off of that in order to dodge, but instead of going for the headband straight up, he jumps right above them, makes another shadow clone, and shoots a wind bullet down from afar. One of these wind bullets hits them and knocks them off course, then Naruto dives down at them at full speed and gets kicked in the jaw by Midoriya and gets caught by a shadow clone before he gets disqualified. After this, Midoriya's headband gets stolen by Todoroki, Naruto steals almost all of Todoroki's headbands except for the 1 million one, and Midoriya steals from Bakugo. Bakugo gets some other headbands right before the time runs out, and this leaves the same four in the top four once again. Of Midoriya, Todoroki, Bakugo, and Naruto's team made it along with a few other teams that made it to the final. This leaves the finals of the UA Sports Festival left, the tournament. And that, everybody, is where I'm going to end part 6 to the What If Naruto Was in MHA series. This was on the longer side of my what ifs, I think, for this series, so I hope you guys appreciate that. If you guys want a part 7, like I said, 300 likes is necessary. I think this is the limit for you guys, Bauer, not going to lie to you guys, but we'll see. If you guys enjoyed the video and haven't already done so, consider subscribing, hitting the bell so you don't miss out on more MHAX Naruto content. Hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, guys, this is AnimeX,
signing off.